if we're clearly defining what it is we are delivering and why, and also what do you need and why, we get back to those conversations, we've automatically begin to open it up into a collaborative discussion.
So much of this seems like it needs to just create clear pathways for that, for each party to have that communication with each other without the others getting involved or getting in the middle. Technology comes into play with this, but how are we looking at creating that pathway for communication and collaboration while still building trust and staying within our lanes, if you will?
A lot of it's going to have to come back at a contract level. We're going to have to make sure that we cannot shift risk. That's something I see happen a lot. There's so many times, especially at the BIM level here in the US, I have been asked to figure it out, get it back to us as the designers, and we'll sign off on it. And there's some hesitancy there. When we run into a problem, we're consistently having issues coordinating over and over and over again. For them to put that out there to say, you figure it out, you work out the design, send it back to us, and we'll approve it. I mean, we've had those types of things happen. We didn't come into that relationship with the right frame of mind. It changes the way you approach it. So I think ultimately all of this has to come back to the project delivery method. I think our project delivery method, our process to get the most out of BIM and to not have an adversarial tone in these conversations, because that's what BIM is doing. You talked about it. Yep. What the whole root of PAS 1192 is about collaboration and communication. And I think that's what we have to step back, and we have to start having conversations earlier.
I think that's exactly it. We've got to get back to actually realizing that if we're clearly defining what it is we are delivering and why, and also what do you need and why, we get back to those conversations, we've automatically begin to open it up into a collaborative discussion. I think clear definition is the one thing that we're always been weak on in the construction industry. And I think that's where a lot of the disparity and contractual clauses come in, is to try and blame people when you're not quite getting the interpretation of what you were expecting at the right time. That's what the UK documents are supposed to be about. It's, you know, the organization that's in charge is actually specifying what information requirements they need for both the asset they're building and specifically then for that project. That's where the BIM execution plan then defines how the team is going to deliver that. But it's about openness. And actually what we find is inherently people know what they've got to produce, but they don't communicate that to other people to know what they're going to expect. And once we get to that point, collaboration starts to become, I'll never say it's easy, you know, because in the end it's all about people. You know, we're getting on okay, we're setting the worlds to right here, but you're going to have a conversation with, you know, another three people down in the bar, and they'll have a totally different opinion. So there's always going to be differences, but to be able to have that conversation and say, right, okay, this is what I understand it to be, this is what I'm going to give you, for the other person to say, okay, that's great, I need this as well. You come to a mutual agreement, and then between you, that gives you the BIM execution plan for the project.
Well, it's communication to the point where you have to do more than email. You have to do more than having a meeting that you've scheduled. I think there are times where people are looking for answers and they have to wait to ask the questions, or we've created so many obstacles in order to talk to the right person. You mentioned contractual language. Typically, an architect can't talk to the subcontractor that you might have on board because you're still negotiating with them. But at some point, I can ask you a question that I need that you can then ask an answer for me. And the problem with the legality that we've built up, the contractual language that we've defined, is not evolving to how we are now working. One of the things that is not in the contract is where are these meetings going to happen? Who's conducting the meetings? How are the agendas written? Who contributes to the meeting notes? Those things end up helping in the communication things and has nothing to do with technology. It's just good business practice. There are so many new tools and technologies out there. I hear creative ways of using apps in the field and Slack channels for conversations and using hashtags to track communication. The generation that is coming up that we hope to recruit to replace us, because we're all going to retire at some point.
Hopefully.
they are in a different level of communication, and I think this is something that we can help educate, and we can help contribute that we know it's more than just a text, it's more than just an email. You might actually have to have a verbal conversation.
That brings a good point. And guys, we all lose that lack of perspective. I mean, think about it. what do you know about fire protection? What do they need on a job? And what can we do to make their jobs easier? What do they need in front of them to do their job? What can we do to help support them on the back end? Yeah. We miss a lot of perspective. Mm-hmm. There's so many moving parts and so many pieces. Mm-hmm. It takes a bigger understanding of that. If I'm going to go out and dig a trench and I'm going to stub up a pipe, I need that person to know that comes back in and fills in that line. Yeah. That don't pack this down and take my pipe that I just spent all this time setting up with a robotic total station to be with an eighth of an inch tolerance to go in this wall, and you come in and pack it down, and now it's 16 inches off to the side.
Yeah.
That person that packed that down didn't know what we needed.
Right.
Didn't understand. They were doing their job, but their job impacted mine.
Yeah.
So we have to
open channels communication.
Absolutely.
Let people understand what it is we've done so that they can do what they need to do.
Absolutely.